beautiful Hera, Mother Divine, wisest Athena, mighty Poseidon, the Earthshaker, Zeus Artemis, with her deadly aim set to pierce into the heart of a hummingbird, painted pigs, all of them. I see you there. Come closer.
Help me! Someone help! Someone!
None of this is your fault. You're the victim. All the mortals are made in the bulwarks of a fool. Jagged reflections from a broken mirror. Behold your god! This one killed 6 innocent children to satisfy her rage. They squabble, burn with jealousy, cheat, fight and murder. They're cruel, vindictive and selfish. And let the heel of Achilles, these witnesses will be their undoing. I have no such flaws. The rest have fallen. Only one stands between me and the rehabilitation of Olympus. Only the foulest, most arrogant, narrow-minded boxer son of Cronos who trapped me beneath the earth. The one and only Zeus!
You, Prometheus, my favorite cousin.
You chained me to this rock and fed my liver to an eagle.
Out of love.
You need my help. Typhon is free.
You once fought beside his allies, the Titans. Convince him to stand down.
It's not that simple. He is even blocking my ability to glimpse the future. I cannot see past him. Go on. Blast me.
I can't! He took my lightning! He took everything! Even the other gods are missing!
Look to the mortals.
That's done! Those evil, imbecilic, tasteless parasites were all turned to stone!
One of those evil parasites is about to save your royal ass.
My ass is safely lodged in the Aegean stables, and mortals will never be anything but a mistake.
Care to make a wager? If I'm right, my sin of stealing fire and ensuring their survival becomes a blessing.
You find your punishment unjust?
It's a little extreme. Do we have a deal?
If you win, I'll end your punishment and set you free. But if I win, you help me stop Typhon, whatever it takes.
Very well. Let the tale of Phoenix be my redemption!
Oh no! Not one of your stories. How long is this going to...
My tale begins at sea. A ship of soldiers returning from a faraway battle. Their victory ambushed by an unexpected storm. The sea tossed and turned. Waves churned to a froth. The line between sky and sea all but vanished. The mountainous peaks of the waves descended into valleys nearly as deep as Tartarus.
You're really painting a picture here.
It's an art. Point is, the ship didn't stand a chance. At dawn, the sun rose on the few remaining survivors. The lowest ranked among them, a shield bearer, who dreamt of battle, but had seen nary a...
Wait! Don't tell me!
The storm! Wake up! I have to wake up!
The storm! Wake up! I have to wake up!
Has a beard.
Like Apollo's chest hair. It's a blonde beard. The color of stirred yogurt. The color of cold lips. A waterfall on the cliffs of Santorini. There, I see her clear as day.
The lowest ranked among them. A shield bearer who dreamt of battle, but had seen nary a skirmish. A teller of tales, not a doer of deeds. Phoenix.
What a name! Phoenix! Sounds like the sound a dumb bird makes when it lights itself on fire. Which would be ridiculous. Although,
I should write that down.
Washed up on an unknown shore, Phoenix awoke.
Can anyone hear me?
Looks like the only way off this beach is up that cliff.
Thank you.
Phoenix saw her captain and fellow soldiers in the distance. Through a trick of the light, she could almost see them waving and calling to her.
Phoenix! Again! You may not be your brother Ligeron, but I will make something of you yet.
Hold my shield. Try not to drop it this time.
I didn't see you there.
Don't let them get to you. They're just jealous. It's not often someone has a brother like yours.
Logogos! Logogos! Can you hear me? You've gone cold. What magic is this? Ligeron, where are you, brother?
Unarmed and lost, Phoenix was vulnerable.
I have to be calm. I have to follow my training. My brother's sword! No! Ligeron! Brother! You've always been my hero, my North Star. I will bring you back. I swear it.
Phoenix had never been allowed to hold the hallowed sword, a gift from Achilles for bravery in battle. It balanced perfectly in her palm, as if forged for it.
Achilles' sword? Brother must have been good in battle.
Is something wrong with your voice?
I never got a sword. Just saying.
Phoenix looked up. She was not alone.
By the gods! Stay back!
She readied her sword for her first real fight. Phoenix felt her training come into focus.
I should be able to survey the land from up there. This is the largest statue of Hermes I've ever seen. I wonder who built it.
Besieged by challenge, totally alone, this young hero was determined to save her fellow soldiers and brother.
Boring! Can we skip this part?
No. This is important for the sense of atmosphere.
My old friend. It's an honor to finally meet you in person. Just don't tell anyone I'm speaking to you. I got in enough trouble for memorizing stories instead of tilling the soil back at home. And then the other soldiers. Well, they really don't appreciate a good story. And my first kiss, all rolled into one.
Phoenix got into the ambrosia too? Prometheus!
You worried, Zeus, about losing this bet?
Please, she can't use it anyway.
Yet. Phoenix's destiny was becoming clear.
So far, all you have shown me is a mortal soldier who has fought one real battle, and Typhon grows stronger by the hour. Don't toy with me, Prometheus!
I swear to you that soldier shall be our salvation. For if she fails and Typhon defeats us, Zeus, king of gods, the world will fall to chaos.
A temple of Apollo! If it has an oracle or a seer, they could help me undo this curse. A griffin? But they aren't real!
Let me go! Help!
Hey! I'll save you! I'm coming! I need to find a way to reach that rift. To get down the pond.
Phoenix felt Ligiron's blade with him.
Get down the pond.
Phoenix felt Ligiron's blade with every step. Its weight a reminder of the heavy responsibility.
You gave him your blade? Oh, Achilles.
I meant to ask, why exactly would you expect to receive a sword from Achilles?
As an offering. Just a routine offering from someone who gazed into your eyes and told you you were special.
That's all. I left a rose on his breastplate.
Got something in my eye. Keep going.
Unlike the mortal flesh, which had been frozen into marble, the pomegranate sprung forth defiantly, bursting with life.
A lot of poetry for something they're just gonna stick in their mouth.
Isn't that what the best poetry is about? Thank you. shed by Typhon's minions, Metal of the Gods, threw itself to Phoenix, as if wanting to be forged into something greater. Muse, sing of Hermes, the luck-bringing messenger of the immortals. He consorts with all mortals and immortals. Little he profits, but through the dark night, he continually tricks.
That's nice. Who wrote that?
My favorite poet, who just happens to not have been born yet.
Can you hear me in there? I'm coming! I found your axe!
Phoenix approached the axe, feeling it call to her.
Looks like the axe of Atalanta. Must be a copy. Although...
But before Phoenix could claim it, the axe was pulled into the pit by a terrible force.
Upon my door.
one?
You think that old trick will work on me? Come into my parlor. Send the Cyclops to the sailor.
Well, that's the end of Phoenix. Perfectly passable storytelling. I won't lie, there were moments that dragged, but you really got me with that ending. Now, let's settle up. Time for you to help me against Typhon.
It's not over yet. Not by a long shot. Was this strange place?
It's Tartarus.
Just exactly where had Phoenix landed?
Tartarus! The nasty abyss where I imprisoned Typhon. He must have opened rifts into the vaults of the underworld when he escaped. You know it, I know it. Say it!
Phoenix was in sure.
I hate you!
But aren't you intrigued?
No. Keep going.
You are either brave, little one, or very foolish. Let's see if you can meet my challenge, or if you will fall like all the others.
Who are you? Hello? Ran her hands over them, noticing that several pieces were missing, as if someone had ripped them apart. They seem to be man-made. I wonder how they work, if they even work. Actually work. Sort of. The axe.
The Axe of Atalanta. Deadliest of hunters. Swiftest of heroes. Fallen at the hands of Typhon.
Didn't I change her into a lion?
You turned a lot of people into a lot of things.
I need to stop drinking. Bolt of my lightning!
Scattered, hidden by Typhon.
It's over! Phoenix is Helios' ash! No one can handle those bolts but me!
Oh, really?
Zeus's lightning bolt? No way!
Power surged through Phoenix. It was too much for her to bear.
What's happening to me?
Bye-bye, mortal!
And then, just like that, it stopped.
No!
The winds grounded the lightning. They were designed to withstand storms.
That shouldn't be possible!
And yet, this is just the beginning. Having plunged into the abyss of Tartarus, and living to tell the tale, Phoenix emerged victorious.
For now?
That stranger I was chasing, where did he go?
With the wings, she would be able to flit across the ancient bridge and find out.
I wouldn't just strap on discarded junk. Who knows where those have been?
Many a night, Phoenix had told tales of a genius. An inventor named Daedalus, and his extraordinary wings. Perhaps someone copied their design, Phoenix mused.
So junk.
Ooh. Maybe it's cursed. Thank you.
A pot? I'll take it with me, just in case. If only Lagiron was here. He's the famous hero, not me. What am I going to do? Put the fiends of Tartaros to sleep with storytelling?
Something down there.
Ha!
Huh.
Morgan? They're real. What's that glimmering? Maybe if I sneak up on it.
Slayer of beasts, defied Hera, and accomplished the impossible wearing those bracers. And now, they belong to Phoenix.
Through damn luck.
Stop! Over here! Fight someone who's armed instead!
Phoenix, after boldly besting the Gorgon that ambushed Heracles.
What are you doing there? That thing with your voice?
Heracles?
Yeah, that!
That is how it's supposed to be pronounced.
Seems like a lot of work, but it's your funeral.
Except I can't die.
Don't remind me.
By the gods! I feel like I could lift a mountain!
If only those bracers could move yes. This one.
Hades alive! You two, get a room!